Blackstone Audiobooks presents Art's Prospect, The Challenge of Tradition in an Age of Celebrity by Roger Kimball. Preface. Out of the Limelight. In his essay, Tradition and the Individual Talent, T.S. Eliot famously criticized our tendency to insist, when we praise a poet, upon those aspects of his work in which he least resembles anyone else. In these aspects or parts of his work, we pretend to find what is individual, what is the peculiar essence of the man. We dwell with satisfaction upon the poet's difference from his predecessors, especially his immediate predecessors. We endeavor to find something that can be isolated in order to be enjoyed. Whereas, if we approach a poet without this prejudice, we shall often find that not only the best, but the most individual parts of his work may be those in which the dead poets, his ancestors, assert their immortality most vigorously. The same argument goes for other arts. Perhaps the chief virtue of Eliot's essay was to remind us of how superficial and artistically limiting the romantic cult of novelty can be. The pretense that the traditional is the enemy rather than the presupposition of originality devalues art's chief source of pertinence, its continuity with the past. Anyone looking for evidence of this does not have far to seek. A quick glance around our culture shows that the avant-garde assault on tradition has long since degenerated into a sclerotic orthodoxy. What established tastemakers now herald as cutting edge turns out time and again to be a stale reminder of past impotence. It is one of history's ironies that romantic fervor regularly declines into antic murmurs. Most of the really invigorating action in the art world today is a quiet affair. It takes place not at Tate Modern or the Museum of Modern Art, not in the Chelsea or Tribeca galleries, but off to one side, out of the limelight. It tends to involve not the latest thing, but permanent things. Permanent things can be new, they can be old, but their relevance is measured not by the buzz they create, but by silences they inspire. Art's Prospect, The Challenge of Tradition in an Age of Celebrity, is intended as an illustration of these truths. It is composed of reviews and essays originally written from the late 1980s through early 2003, and mostly revised for this volume. It is not a chronicle, but rather a direct sampling, culled and arranged with an eye to illuminating some of the chief spiritual itineraries of contemporary art. Accordingly, this brief book makes no claim to completeness. What I have tried to provide is a collage whose elements, when seen from one perspective, add up to a diagnosis of a malady, and, when seen from another perspective, provide hints of where effective remedies can be found. I am under no illusion that this will be a popular book. Many of the figures I criticize currently enjoy semi-beatified status in the art establishment, while many I praise are routinely vilified or effectively ignored. Still, there is something to be said for stepping back from the great media parade of contemporary culture now and again to point out that many of those proclaimed to be emperors are in fact stark naked. By the same token, it is worth calling attention to some of the many talents that, for one reason or another, the celebrity parade decided to pass by without, or with only insufficient, notice. Art's Prospect, Part 1. The Museum as Funhouse. Funhouse, noun. A building or an attraction in an amusement park that features various devices intended to surprise, frighten, or amuse. The American Heritage Dictionary. I threw the bottle rack and the urinal into their faces as a challenge, and now they admire them for their aesthetic beauty. Marcel Duchamp, 1946. Everyone knows that American culture has undergone drastic changes over the last several decades. Perhaps no cultural institution has changed more drastically in that time than the art museum. 40 years ago, the typical art museum was a staid and stately place. Its architecture, often neoclassical, tended to suggest grandeur and to elicit contemplation. Soaring columns and marble halls, bespoken opulence of purpose as well as material wealth.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.